So never has a device in our specialty so well supported by clinical studies. And we have to pay tribute to Tom Wilder, who was the CEO of Sequent, and Amy Walters, who was responsible for clinical research at Sequent, to start those clinical studies, including the Claris study. And then it was followed by the Microvention team, which were providing a lot of support for those clinical studies. And I would like to pay tribute to Patricia Boyer, who is providing a lot of help to sort all those data. So that will be a little bit tough because you will have quite a lot of data today, including in this presentation. So my disclosure, it's among the different companies. I'm a consultant for Microvention. So you know already through the European study and the US study that the web is safe and efficient for non-ruptured aneurysms. And we know also that it takes time to be efficient because it allows progressive obliteration of the aneurysm. The question we had very soon after we have started to use the web was whether or not the speed of obliteration within the web was fast enough to treat a ruptured aneurysm. And this is why was conducted the Claris study to evaluate the potential ability of the web to prevent from an early rebleeding. Secondly, when we got the Web 17, the price to pay was to, of course, we were having a decrease in the profile of the microcatheter, and of course the device has changed, and the main question was, does the decrease of the profile of the Web 17 maintain both the safety and efficiency? And this is what the reason why was conducted the CLEVER study, which was enrolling both unruptured mainly, but also ruptured aneurysm. So for tonight, we'll be focusing on the ruptured arm of the CLEVER study. So the CLARIS was designed to enroll only ruptured aneurysm, conversely to CLEVER, which was enrolling both, but it was enrolling quite a large amount of ruptured aneurysm, 60. CLARIS was performed with the generation of Web 21, conversely to CLEVER, which was dealing with Web 17. So this is the period of enrollment. I want to stress on the two-year period of enrollment for the CLEVER study, which was very fast. And the CLARIS was conducted in 13 sites. CLEVER was conducted in 20 sites. We do have nowadays the final data at 12 months, which were published by the GNIS yesterday. And for the CLEVER, we only have interim data at 1 month. Please be very aware that it's both of them, they are prospective, single arm, multi-center study. The pictures are evaluated by an independent core lab with James Byrne. There was an independent event adjudication for the studies, which is Laurent Pierrot, and it was 100% monitored by a third-party company, an external company outside Microvention, which was coming to the different centers. So let's have a look to those two studies dealing with ruptured aneurysm. So CLARIS was enrolling ruptured aneurysm less than 1 month, conversely to CLEVER, which was enrolling both ruptured and non-ruptured, but they had to be at a bifurcation level. We had some additional criteria for ruptured aneurysm. First, the patient should not be too severe because the subarachnoid hemorrhage is a very severe disease, and we would have lost quite a lot of patients along the follow-up, so they should be less or equal to 3. And secondly, I will stress on that on the next slide, we had to perform a CT scan within the 6 hours prior to femoral puncture. This was absolutely mandatory. So we come now to the study endpoints. And the CLARIS, we have to separate CLARIS and CLEVER. CLARIS was purely dedicated to look at the rebleeding rate from post-procedure up to 1 month. And this is why we spend a lot of time to carefully design the protocol to monitor any re-bleeding, any bleeding that could occur after the placement of the web up to 1 month, because we know that this is the risky period of re-bleeding. And we wanted absolutely to avoid having in this cohort the perioperative bleeding. So this is why we had to perform a lot of screening for the re-bleeding during the procedure. A CT inside the angio suite was performed before the treatment and systematically after the treatment to check if there was any bleeding during the treatment, because you have to separate completely bleeding due to the placement of the web from bleeding which is due to the inability of the web to prevent from an early re-bleeding. And then, I'm very sorry, can you just move a little bit away, because otherwise I will lost. Thank you very much. And then we had to perform a CT each time there was a worsening of the clinical status of the patient just after the treatment up to 1 month. The re-bleeding was carefully defined. That was a re-bleeding from the aneurysm which has ruptured. It has to be, of course, visible on the CT and the MR. It has to be depicted in the same territory as the initial bleeding. And, of course, we had to observe an increase in size in the bleeding. So this very important feature was evaluated by the core lab and by the CA. Conversely, the CLEVER study had a composite primary endpoint, which was dealing with both safety and efficacy. For the safety, it was the evaluation of the complication, death or major stroke at 1 month and at 1 year. And there was also an efficacy point, which was the evaluation of the angiographic occlusion a year after the treatment. Both were evaluated for the safety by the CA and for the picture by the core lab. Then you had some secondary endpoint for CLARIS, which are listed here, and also for the CLEVER. So I will not spend too much time about that, but I will present the relevant result during this presentation. CLARIS was conducted in 2 countries, in France and in Germany. CLEVER was conducted in 5 countries, Finland, France, Germany, Hungary, and UK. Population aneurysm description, this is quite interesting. So for both studies, you have understood that there are the same amount of patients, 60, slightly older in the CLEVER study, slightly more patient, slightly more women in the CLEVER study. Very interesting, you have quite a high rate of hypertension and of smoker in both studies dealing with ruptured aneurysm. This is the clinical score of the patient when they were included in the study. So you see that once it was equally distributed between NNS 1, 2, and 3, conversely to CLEVER, where you had more than 50% of the patients who were NNS 2. Aneurysm size, so here is listed the sizes of the aneurysm, and you can see that in CLARIS, the aneurysm for sure were larger, but we remind you that the WEB 21 was used, conversely to CLEVER, where the WEB 17 was used, and it's obvious that we were able to treat smaller aneurysm and look that the smaller aneurysm which was treated in CLEVER was measuring less than 2 millimeters, even it has ruptured. Aneurysm location is very, very interesting because at the CLARIS, we were mainly dealing with MCA, bifurcation, and NACOM aneurysm. The new feature is that in CLEVER, we had 20% of the patients that had an aneurysm treated with the web located on the PCOM. So this has decreased, surprisingly, the amount of patients with MCA bifurcation aneurysm. And if you look at the proportion of MCA, it's smaller in Clever compared to MCA. And you have the PCOM, of course. When you deal with the Clever non-rupture, you come back to something which is more or less known and presented by Laurent Perrault. It's the majority of the patients were treated with MCA or ACOM location. It was possible to deploy the web in almost all the treatment. So almost all in Claris, we had a failure for 4 patients, conversely to Clever, where it was possible to implant the web. And this is, again, because of the small web available in the Clever study. Very interesting is that in more than 80%, the first web which was chosen was the one which was detached. So it's happened in a very few moments that we had to use a second web. Interestingly, it's probably due to the increase in our experience. It has never happened in Clever that we had to use a third web, which was happening for the Claris study. You see how stable the fluoroscopy time between the two studies. It's less than 30 minutes, the fluoroscopy time. And this is something which is observed by everybody using the web, especially the young generation. They like it because it's very fast, less than 30 minutes. So the main point was the looking at the protection of the web 21 or the web 17 against a bleeding. So you know that when you deploy a web in the ruptured aneurysm, most of the time, the aneurysm is still circulating after the detachment of the web. So you could wonder whether or not the patient could bleed again. And there is no re-bleeding among those two series of a patient with ruptured aneurysm. Then we have to carefully look at the perioperative adverse event. So here, not to hide anything, are listed all the perioperative events with or without clinical consequences. First of all, you see that it were quite a lot. You have 23 within 18 patients in Claris and 14 within 12 patient in Clever ruptured arm. But what you can see is that most of them were without any clinical consequences. Secondly, thromboembolic event were the vast majority of the complication, and it was carefully sorted between two different kinds of thromboembolic complication. Without any perfusion deficit, with a perfusion deficit, with a stroke, or with a thrombosis of the parent vessel, or a branch arising at the level of the neck. You see that this thromboembolic complication, they may happen, they may be seen on the angiogram, but most of them, they didn't have any clinical consequences. Intraoperative rupture has occurred. It's very, very seldom. 2 patients in Claris and 1 patient in Clever. So this is a slide which is a little bit busy, just for you to see which complications are related to the web. You see it is a minority, and which complications are related either to the web or to the procedure. Very important is the clinical follow-up at 1 month and then at 1 year. So the morbidity was 1.7% in Claris and 0%, which doesn't look to be serious, but it is the case. We didn't have any morbidity in the Clever study. So I'm sorry, there is a mistake in this slide. It should read mortality and not morbidity. I'm sorry. So I say it again, it's 1.7% mortality in Claris and 0% mortality in Clever. The death we had in Claris was not related to the web. It was a huge vasospasm that has occurred a week after the initial subarachnoid hemorrhage. And now there is another mistake, which is not the mortality, but the morbidity. at 1 month, very surprisingly, the morbidity is equivalent in both studies, which is 15%. 15%, if you look at Claris, it was due to 9 patients not related to the web, 9 patients also for Clever, but one morbidity was related to the web. It was a thrombus at the level of the neck. We then evaluated the clinical presentation a year, but this concerned only Claris, because for Clever, we only have result at 1 month. So you have to see the chart. Initially, we had 60 patients with 60 aneurysms, and 4 patients didn't receive the web, and for 4 patients, there was no visit at one year. So for the 1 year follow-up, we have to look at 52 patients instead of 60 at the beginning. So this is the morbidity of 10.2% at 1 year, and 4.1% mortality at 1 year. Mortality, the 2 deaths are not related to the web. One has already been described in the previous slide. It was a huge vasospasm a week after the treatment. And another death has occurred at 4 months, which is a general condition of the patient after the initial subarachnoid hemorrhage. But there was absolutely no new hemorrhage visible on the different examination. The morbidity was dealing with 5 patients. It was not related to the web, and they were all reported at 1 month, so nothing new between 1 month and 1 year. Finally, angiographic follow-up. It has been performed only in Claris at 1 year. So, of course, we still have the 4 patients for whom we didn't deploy the web. We had 2 deaths. And 4 patients who didn't come, and 4 patients with missed examination. For the 1 year follow-up in Claris, it's for 46 patients. So we have a slightly smaller amount of complete occlusion in this study dealing with ruptured aneurysm. It's 41%, which is not as good as expected. Usually with all the studies, WebIT or webcast is around 55. But the complete, the adequate occlusion is almost the same. It's 87%. Regarding the retreatment rate, again, it's higher. It's probably probably biased by the fact that we are more prone to treat again a patient when you have a recurrence because it was a ruptured aneurysm. So retreatment rate at 1 year is 11.5%. So to conclude, we have now 120 patients with a ruptured aneurysm, Claris 60 patients with a Web21, Clever 60 patients with the Web17. Important, 0 rebleeding at 1 month. There is a confirmation of the very high safety of the web, very efficacy of the web without any rebleeding at 1 year in the Claris study. The occlusion results are similar to the other web studies with 87% of adequate occlusion. So finally, and I would like to thank all the participating centers, these are the 2 papers, one with the clinical follow-up and the other one with the angiographic follow-up. And I just want to stress on this sentence, which is obviously the web will lead probably to a completely change in the management of ruptured bifurcation aneurysm.